All of us live in a little bubble of reality, and we think that's all there is, our little bubble of experience. Now, let me share with you an idea that might seem totally crazy to you, but I want to share it anyway. Starting with the notion that we are living in a particular bubble of perceptual experience that becomes our reality. And then we hang out with people who are living in similar bubbles. So let's entertain the idea that every person is a unique timeline of cosmic history. So bear with me, because if you grasp what I'm saying, it will have a profound influence on your identity. So the notion that every person is a unique timeline of cosmic history is also a profound reflection on the interconnectedness of human existence with the broader universe. What I'm saying suggests that each individual carries within them the echoes of cosmic, biological, and cultural evolution, making them a microcosm of the universe. Of course, this has been expressed before, you know, that we are a microcosm of the universe. So let's explore how the universe's many simultaneous but different timelines are mirrored in the unique existence of every person. The universe's history is, of course, a complex tapestry woven from countless events over billions of years. From the Big Bang, approximately, and remember, this is a scientific model, but nevertheless, with a lot of empirical evidence. Okay. From the Big Bang, approximately 13.8 billion years ago, to the formation of stars, galaxies, and eventually planets, the cosmos has undergone continuous transformation. Key events such as cosmic inflation, nucleosynthesis, and the formation of the first stars and galaxies have shaped the universe as we observe it today. In fact, what we observe is the past of the universe. Then there's biological evolution, the timeline of life. Life on Earth is a product of billions of years of biological evolution, from the simplest unicellular organisms to the complex multicellular life forms that populate the planet today. Evolution has driven the diversification and adaptation of life. Human beings, as part of this evolutionary process, carry within their DNA the genetic legacy of countless generations of life forms. In fact, it's well known that 65% of your genes are the same as a banana. And then there's cultural evolution. Cultural evolution refers to the development of human societies through the transmission of knowledge, beliefs, and practices. This process has echoed humans to create complex civilizations, develop languages, art, science, and now technology. Cultural evolution is a testament to human ingenuity and adaptability shaping our interactions and understanding of the world. So the microcosm-macrocosm analogy posits that humans are a smaller representation of the larger universe. This ancient philosophical concept suggests that the structure and processes within the human body reflect those of the cosmos. For example, just as the universe is composed of various elements and forces, so too is the human body composed of similar elements, all originating from stardust. And then there is the interconnectedness of timelines. The universe is not a single linear timeline, but a multitude of simultaneously interwoven timelines. Each event in the cosmic history has led to the formation of new structures and phenomena. Similarly, each person represents a unique timeline shaped by their individual experiences, genetic makeup, and cultural background. This interconnectedness highlights the idea that every person is a walking universe, a snapshot of the broader cosmic history. And now it gets more interesting. The concept of parallel timelines and multiple histories further enriches our understanding of human existence within the cosmos. In theoretical physics, parallel timelines suggest that different versions of events can coexist, each leading to different outcomes. The idea can be applied to human lives where each person's choices and experiences create a unique timeline, distinct yet interconnected with others. So, this leads to an even more interesting question. How do different theories of time travel reconcile with the concept of parallel timelines? So first, of course, I'm sure you've heard of the multiverse theory. This theory aligns well with parallel timelines, proposing that every possible outcome of a quantum event creates a new universe. In this view, time travel doesn't change the past, but rather moves the traveler to a parallel timeline where the changes occur. And this resolves paradoxes by allowing multiple histories to coexist. So, do you as a person have multiple histories? And there's also something called branch reality theory. Similar to multiverse theory, this approach suggests that changes to the past don't rewrite history, but split the timeline into an alternative branch, the rigid timeline remains unchanged, creating a new parallel reality. And then there's, of course, the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics, which says that multiple states of existence for particles are possible simultaneously. And when applied to time travel, it implies that each quantum outcome creates a new world or timeline, reconciling time travel with the idea of parallel universes. And then there's something else called multiple histories approach. This theory, proposed by some physicists, suggests that allowing for multiple histories, parallel timelines, can resolve paradoxes that other theories cannot. It proposes that when a time traveler goes to the past, they enter a different timeline, avoiding paradoxes in the original timeline. So these paradoxes, you probably heard the grandfather paradox, if I can travel into the past and I kill my grandfather, then I shouldn't exist because, I'm offspring of a person that I've killed. But if there are several timelines, then in many, many timelines, the grandfather is dead and alive at the same time, like Schrödinger's cat. So there's many approaches. In fact, David Deutsch proposed a quantum solution to the grandfather paradox. In this model, quantum effects allow for multiple histories to coexist, resolving apparent paradoxes at the quantum level. This approach has been experimentally simulated, offering some support for its validity. So, my friends, there's not one of you. There could be infinite of you, infinite versions of you, the one who's listening to me and watching me right now. From outside of space-time. This is only one timeline in the infinite parallel histories of the universe. What do you think of this? Does it have any practical applications on who we are? What is our true identity? So I posit to you, our true identity, once again, is that formless being that can manifest in many timelines simultaneously, including so-called persons coexisting in many timelines simultaneously. As we grasp these models, as we explore these models through mathematics, through scientific inquiry, through fundamental physics, through large language models, we are entering a new era where our experience of reality is about to revise itself in a way that we never dreamed of. Reality, so-called reality, is subject to revision in almost infinite modes of knowing and experience. So, anyway, digital dharma is out, and you can engage with me on this or any other conversation by going to digitaldeepak.ai. Take care, my friends. Right now, we are only experiencing one version of yourself. Is it possible to experience infinite versions of yourself? Let me know your thoughts and engage with me on digitaldeepak.ai. Have a great day.